and I inserted the transistor right in that template. This is all done automatically without having to do any setup now. Just insert the device in the template and push simulate. This helps the designer to establish the Q bias point in order to start the design. So you can see the output automatically comes, giving you the current and the voltage where you want to bias your LNE and the DC power consumption, you know, at that bias point. So having found this bias point, the voltage and current, now we have to add the appropriate bias lines and the stability resistors that provide the required bias and stability for this LNE. Next, generating the gain and noise circle is done very easily and automatically in ADS. Again, designers can drag palettes. You see on the left side of the screen, designers can drag those palettes on the schematic page. These palettes are pre-generated functions that automatically produce the gain and noise circles. Maximum gain, stability circles, stability measures, and many, many other useful functions. So the gain and noise circles here will help us find a proper matching impedance point that will produce the gain and noise figure that meet our specs. So you can see I placed those icons right on the schematic, and all I have to do is just push simulate now, and it will provide me with this plot, the noise circles and the gain circles with the maximum gain and noise figure and other information. Now you can see marker 1 and marker 2 are very close to each other. One is in the noise circles and the other one is in the gain circles. They are very close and they give us about, you can read here, it gives 11.3 dB gain and 1.52 dB noise figure. So that M1 and M2 shows the location of Z0 on the Smith chart. That's if we match our circuit at the input to this, we will achieve that noise figure and that gain. Without any matching right now, the way it is, just the FET with the lines, the bias lines and the stability resistors, it is shown here that the gain is 8.75 dB. And the maximum gain I can extract from this device is 12.8 dB if I match it at the input and the output. So this is the maximum gain. So therefore, let's choose Z0, shown here, which is like a compromise between gain and noise figure, that will give me that 11.3 dB gain and 1.52 dB noise figure. We have to match our input matching network to this point. Having known that Z0, you know, the match point, designer can go in the tools menu in ADS and they can start the impedance matching tool. The impedance matching tool is located in the tools pull down menu and can automatically find a good matching network for any given impedance points, just like Z0 of the last page we have. So I use this impedance matching tool to find right at the input my matching network, which will provide me that impedance point that would give me the noise and the gain spec. So repeating the same process from this matching tool, but for the output matching network now, this is our final amp with both input and output matching networks, input and output matching networks. As mentioned earlier, notice on the left side there are many automated measurements available. They are pre-configured equations that designers can drag into the schematic page and get the results automatically without having to do any equations or setup. In this example here, I have used the stability icons, and the results will be shown automatically once I simulate the design. I have stability factor, stability measure, mu, and mu prime. All these are related to stability. So once I hit simulate, automatically it will give me the results. This is the tabulated results, which can be also plotted as well. mu1, mu prime, stability factor are all greater than 1, and the stability measure is positive, all of these are required to have an unconditionally stable amp. Now we can plot the gain and the return loss and the noise figure. So here the simulation results of the first cut LNA. Our gain is 11.8 dB. Our spec is 11 dB. So we meet the spec here. The noise figure is 1.75 dB and our spec is 1.85 dB. So we meet the spec. And the S22 is minus 25 dB. Our matching network is very good and it provided us with minus 25 dB of return loss. Our spec is minus 15 dB or lower. So we meet specs. It looks very decent. It looks nice. So here the results look very good. But you might think right now we are done. We can proceed to the layout and go on and proceed to fabrication. First, before we do this, let us see how this low noise amp perform with the foundry process variation here. Results look very good. But you might think right now we are done. We can proceed to the layout and go on and proceed to fabrication. First, before we do this, let us see how this low noise amp perform with the foundry process variation. So let us find how manufacturable or how does this LNA perform to this foundry process and what is the predicted yield. We ran Monte Carlo yield analysis to this amplifier and the process variation we used is shown on the top left of this page. So you can see I varied 5% plus or minus 5% uniform variation in the lumped elements. I varied the line widths plus or minus half a micron. The substrate height is 100 micron, but I varied it plus or minus 3 micron. And the dielectric constant is 12.9, and I varied it plus or minus 5%. So with these variations, I ran 200 trials of Monte Carlo yield analysis, and look at my yield. It's 27.5%. 27.5% yield out of this amplifier. And you can see shown in the red lines in the middle is the spec. And look at the distribution, how wide the distribution and the sensitivity of the amplifier to those variations. So basically what happened, the process variation have caused the response to shift out from its nominal response and caused all these failures. Next, I will introduce you to the next step in our design flow. It is unique tools in ADS that will transform this design into a robust design with high yield and low sensitivity. These are the set of DFM, designed for manufacturing tools, in ADS which consist of design of experiment, DOE, yield sensitivity histograms, sensitivity analysis, and the high yielding impedance matching tool, which helps you to find a robust matching network. These tools together will help you transform this design or any design into a robust and high yielding design to ensure first pass success with lowest cost. So let's see this. In the design flow, this is where the DFM cycle comes in. Right after the schematic capture and the initial design, we want to go through this design for manufacturing process to convert our design into solid, robust, high-yielding design before proceeding to the physical design stage. So the DFM part happens up front and before we move to the physical design part. It's important to have a solid, robust design topology before we proceed to the physical design part.